Newfoundland railroaders, a story I must tell. About a West Coast legend the engineers knew well. He lived out in the Rickhouse Valley, close down by the sea. Kept the trains a-moving at mile 533. Over with the railroad line complete in 1898. Those Rickhouse storms would often keep the locals running late. The engineers all said we need some warning now and then. And lucky is our man, they said, 'cause he can smell the wind.
When the frost is on the mountain and it's zero down below, when it's slick down in November and the big southeasters blow, you can hear him on the siding sending signals down the line, ordering the engineers to stop old number nine.
Now Lockie held his hand up high to get a reading true, then radioed the engineers to stop at Riverview. And when the storm was over, he'd radio again, saying, whack her up and put her through, boys, you can beat the wind.
When the frost is on the mountain and it's zero down below, when it's late down in November and the big southeasters blow, you can hear them on the siding sending signals down the line, ordering the engineers to stop old number nine.
Then to his waiting trap lines he would pack his bags and go, across the valleys and the bogs in ice and wind and snow. Farming in the summertime kept his family fed. No time for idle fingers on the old Rickhouse homestead.
When the frost is on the mountain and it's zero down below, when it's late down in November and the big southeasters blow, you can hear him on the siding sending signals down the line, ordering the engineers to stop old number nine.
One day in 47, a load of westbound freight come hauling into Corner Brook 15 hours late. Orders at the station told them what to do. Cool steam for Port of Bass, boys, gotta get her through. But Lockie read the storm clouds and warned them not to go. He said there's weather coming and tonight she's gonna blow. They said we have our orders, we're not delaying much. Next morning 30 boxcars pile up in McDougal's coach.
When the frost is on the mountain and it's zero down below, when it's late down in November and the big southeasters blow, you can hear him on the siding sending signals down the line, ordering the engineers to stop old number nine.
Disappeared, there's not a track in sight. No more you'll hear those lonesome whistles screaming through the night. Lockie's long since passed away, the old homestead is gone. But stories of that human wind gauge still linger on. For sometimes in the evening of a big southeastern gale, when 18-wheelers barrel down across that Rickhouse trail, truckers say they see him, finger to the sky, slowing down the big machines as they go rolling by.
When the frost is on the mountain and it's zero down below, when it's late down in November and the big southeasters blow, you can hear him on the siding sending signals down the line, ordering the engineers to stop old number nine. Ordering the engineers to stall number nine.